So Hugh, a patient has just been told they have non-muscle invasive bladder cancer. What does that mean?
So bladder cancer really refers to having a cancer primarily in the lining of the bladder. It commonly presents with blood in the urine, and we use a small telescope called a cystoscope to look inside. And because the cancers arise from the lining of the bladder, they're visible to us when we look inside the bladder with a cystoscope. And then bladder cancer is divided into two broad categories. One is called non-muscle invasive bladder cancer, which basically means the cancer is confined to the lining and the inner layer of the bladder, whereas muscle invasive bladder cancer means it's spread into the muscle wall of the bladder, which is potentially more serious.
And if someone's been told that they have BCG or they need to have BCG treatment, what is that and what should they do to prepare for their first BCG treatment?
So BCG is a really interesting treatment because we loosely call it either chemotherapy or sometimes intravesical therapy. BCG was originally developed as a vaccine to immunize people against getting tuberculosis. And many years ago, people discovered that patients who'd been immunized with BCG had fewer bladder cancer recurrences than people who hadn't. And that led to initially people being given a series of BCG injections and then finally giving BCG directly into the bladder. So it's quite unique in cancer because it's what we call an immunotherapy. So the drug itself doesn't kill the cancer cells in the normal way that, for example, chemotherapy does. What it does is that it stimulates your immune system to mount an immune response. And we know that your immune system actually can be very effective at fighting cancer. And in some ways, I think we're quite lucky that bladder cancer is uniquely sensitive to the effects of BCG. In terms of patients preparing themselves for BCG, I do always say to patients that we are putting a bacteria, a very weakened bacteria, but nevertheless a foreign bacteria into your bladder. And so inevitably there is a reaction against that, and that reaction causes inflammation, it will cause pain, it will cause patients to need to go to the toilet more frequently. A lot of this comes under the umbrella of what we call cystitis. But I think with the right explanation, and in particular, we're extremely lucky in urology that our bladder cancer nurses have all had many, many years of experience before they even are in a position to give BCG, that we can support most patients through that.
And so if a patient then goes home and finds that they're having some discomfort, what should they do?
So we always make sure that the patients have got a contact. And I think the first thing they should do is to contact us. Pretty much most urology departments will give you a direct phone number. And I think I always advise patients just to contact us directly, because even if you have reasonably good contact with your GP, they'll probably won't be as experienced as we are. Fortunately, in most cases, after some reassurance, we don't need to do anything else. But please just contact your urology department and they'll do the rest.
And when you say that BCG is put inside the bladder, what is that like? How does that happen?
So the course of BCG, unfortunately, one course isn't enough. So in order to get the drug into the bladder, the nurse will, after discussing it with you, insert a small disposable catheter. Now, that is only there for a few minutes to allow the BCG to be introduced into the bladder, and then the catheter comes out. And the BCG itself is just a colorless, odorless liquid. It goes into the bladder, the catheter comes out, and we ask that you keep it in the bladder for a couple of hours, and the drug then is able to coat the entire lining of the bladder and have its desired effect.
And sometimes patients can be a little apprehensive about their first BCG installation. What do patients say to you after their first BCG installation?
Well, the majority of them are quite pleasantly surprised. In general, people are always apprehensive about having to have a catheter inserted. But when they see that it's a very flexible, slippery catheter, and that it's not going to be something that they have to walk around with or do anything like that, that tends to help. One thing I always say to patients is that we will take it on a week-by-week basis. In other words, please feed back to us. And it's not, the end of the world if you have severe side effects or significant side effects and we have to stop. I mean, one thing that I always emphasize to patients is that we have removed the cancer from your bladder. The BCG isn't there to kill any cancer cells that are there in your bladder that we've left behind. It's a preventative measure to try and stop any new cancers from coming back into your bladder in the future. And so, you know, we try and give patients, for example, to begin with 6 installations of BCG, but if we get to 3 or 4 and their side effects become quite severe, it's not the end of the world. We stop at that point and then we carry on looking inside their bladder. So the time period is pretty much a week, and what we tend to do is to pick a certain day and time of the week that works for patients, and then they just come back in at the same time every week that suits them. Sometimes patients ask whether they can have if they have a holiday or something else that crops up, because often the maintenance part of BCG can go on for months, if not 1 or 2 years. And I always say to them, as long as we broadly stick to the schedule, moving the schedule around by a few weeks here and there isn't going to make a difference. And if you've got a holiday or a special occasion coming up, we can always stop the BCG for that particular week or couple of weeks and then just pick up, and it won't make any difference.
And what does the maintenance period generally look like?
So broadly speaking, every patient will have at least 1 year of maintenance. So after the first 6 weeks of installation, they'll get another 3 installations at 3 months, 6 months, and 12 months. There are some patients who have a special type of non-muscle invasive cancer called carcinoma in situ, and we know they would benefit from having another 2 years of maintenance on top of that, so it would be 3 years in total. So it's somewhere between 1 to 3 years.
And what happens at the end of that?
So at the end of that, we know that giving you any more BCG doesn't give you any additional benefits. So you just would be getting the side effects without having the benefits. So the patients who are on BCG would always have lifelong surveillance with cystoscopy. And again, the frequency of that varies. To begin with, it's usually every 3 months. The further out you get, it tends to go over to 6 months. And pretty much after about year 3 or 4 of being on maintenance, if you've been clear, we can sometimes even go to annual cystoscopies. I've got plenty of patients who finished their BCG quite a long time ago. They come once a year for me to have a look inside their bladder, and the rest of the time they just lead a normal life.
Thank you.